joining me now, my all-star panel to break it all down, Republican strategist and Donald Trump surrogate Boris Epstein and former aide to Democratic Senator Chuck Schumer, Chris Hahn. All right, guys, I'm going to start with you, Chris.
Yes.
I mean, what is Bernie doing?
Look, he's got a primary on Tuesday. He's going to tell his supporters, vote for me, I could still win. He knows in his heart of hearts he can't. He also knows that Tuesday's his last stand to make any play for the convention. He has no chance. She's won the majority of votes. She's won the majority of pledged delegates. She's won the majority of superdelegates.
But
he's lost all three categories.
To convention. He can still
he's
go not and
gonna,
disrupt
not
it.
Going to happen. Within a week of Tuesday, you will see a complete 180
what
from Bernie
What are they
going
to give Bernie to... Stop.
I think he's going to have a very big role in creating the platform of the
What's
Democratic
the platform?
Party. Look,
okay,
that's what he wants.
I'm going to go to you, Boris. Let's assume the platform is a very left platform. By Hillary moving left, she, in the hopes of capturing those millennials of Bernie's, loses the independence, does she not?
Absolutely. And a lot of those blue dog Democrats, too, which are very important in the key states of Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania. So Bernie is unquestionably hurting the party. They're having the Menshevik-Bolshevik split the Communist Party had in the early 1900s, and the Democrats are having the same thing, and it's great for the Republican Party. Let me finish. And it allows Donald Trump to stay on message, continue to attack Hillary, who is going to be the nominee.
Okay. It would be nice if he stayed on message. I don't know what his message is. It's all over the map. But I will say this, though. Look, there will be a coming together of the party. It happens every couple of years.
Okay, you already said that. Now, let's talk about your candidate.
Go ahead.
180 days.
Yes.
The woman has not had a press conference.
I believe that when you run for public office, you should appear in public. I think she should have a press conference.
No, when
conference,
she does, she has like a rope in front of her.
I'm not going to defend that. You should take all comers. You should take all questions when you're
on
phone.
So why isn't she?
I don't know. And frankly, I think
the reason that she doesn't want to be asked about Benghazi, most of all, she does not want to be asked about the email scandal.
Because anything she says can and will be used against her.
She goes on the morning shows, they ask her about Benghazi and the email scandal anyway. And she goes on the morning shows every
day. Did you see her with George Stephanopoulos?
I did see that.
He went at her.
He did, and I think it was very clear that he wanted to say, "Look, I work for Clinton, but I'm a reporter," and he did what he had to do there. And I think she handled herself pretty
no,
pretty
she
well.
Didn't. So you think she fine. Did?
Terrible. She does this two-step every time. When asked last week, she said, "I had the email server set up because I didn't know how to access my emails on the PC." You know what? The American public are not buying it. That's why her truth numbers are below 10.
She's got to come
below
out
10%
and say,
of people believe
or
her.
She's got to come out and say, I have been in public life for the last 30 years. People have been attacking me. I wanted a little privacy in my email. That's why I did it.
No,
I should have done it.
And that's why
you
I broke
believe
federal
that?
Law.
I think that's what you should have done.
Let
and
me
I don't
ask
think
you
she
a question.
Broke any law. It's
you
ex
know
post
what
facto.
I think is amazing?
Yes, ma'am.
Bernie is starting to talk about the money to the foundation while she was Secretary of State and her husband was collecting money.
Yeah, I think Bernie needs to stop doing that.
You know what?
Oh, why?
He'll stop doing
because
it. We'll keep
it's
doing
ridiculous.
It. They have to restate 4 years of tax returns because they took money from sovereign funds.
Oh, well, if we want to talk about tax returns, I'm waiting to see Donald.
We already know about the Clinton Foundation tax returns and the fact that the New York Times, New York Times wrote a story.
We know about it because
about
they've
the
been
Russian
released.
Government, the Russian government funneling money to the Clinton Foundation.
When is Donald Trump going to release his tax returns?
Donald has not released his tax returns. He says he's being audited. But with Hillary, Chris, don't you think there's a bit of a difference? She's Secretary of State, getting money to her family's foundation, dealing with all these foreign countries while money is going to her. In other words, she's a government. She's our representative to the world.
Everybody acknowledges that the Clinton Foundation did great work. It's being politicized.
Who's everybody?
George W. Bush has spoken at the Clinton Foundation. Republicans and Democrats and independents and people from around this political spectrum have been involved with it before she was running for office, and now it's the evil empire.
Before she was running for office. It wasn't existed before she ran for office.
No, let me tell you something. They created the foundation when they were leaving the White House. Remember, she had to return like $200,000 worth of stuff they took with them? But that's another issue.
No, it's going to be the foundation will be very ugly for her.
Depends. And I think that what's so interesting, I think she sent a message today. Hillary Clinton, when she was talking to George Stephanopoulos, said, everybody in government knew that I was using an email server. Everybody knew about it. You know what that tells me? That tells me that she's saying, all you people who answered me on my private email address on my private server are complicit, Mr. President, you know, and all you other dignitaries. She just put the punch right out there that I heard loud and clear.
That sounds like obstruction of justice to me. Scaring other witnesses sounds like obstruction of justice. Now, she tried to say that other secretaries of state did the same thing, which was a lie.
Every secretary of state before her did the same thing.
Colin Powell had a Gmail account or something. What Secretary of State had a private server?
I think they were using...
The answer is a name. Give me a name.
Well, hold on a minute. They all used private email.
Answer my question.
They used public servers, which was worse.
They used a government server.
No. They used private email accounts. They used, like, Yahoo.
Incorrect.
I mean, it's giving me a parade.
I am absolutely not. I'm trying to fool the American people. It's very unfair.
Look, the truth is, no one else had a private server.
That's right.
She did. And the question to the American people is why. Anyway, we're just getting a report now that Hillary wins Puerto Rico. We've got 60 delegates in Puerto Rico. Still not enough, though, to put her through the to the number she needs that she'll probably get on Tuesday in New Jersey. But we'll see. Again, Hillary Clinton winning Puerto Rico. Those results just in. Now, one more thing, guys. This guy, David French, who's supposed to be a third-party candidate, has issued a statement saying he's not the right person to challenge Hillary and Donald Trump, but the path remains open for others.
Bill Kristol probably is coming up with another one somewhere back there. But you know what's interesting? The Quinnipiac poll had just Clinton and Trump. Clinton was up by four. Clinton, Trump, Johnson, and Stein. Clinton lost 5 points. Trump only lost two. So the other vote, the other candidates are taken away from Clinton more than they're taken away from Trump. And that's very interesting.
Quickly, I got
look, Mr. French writes a great blog on Game of Thrones, and I enjoyed it very much.
Who is this guy?
Bill Kristol, I loved him in Soap, but he's never made a good prediction on politics in the last 30 years.
Here's a prediction:
Forrest
Trump president.
Chris Hahn, thanks for the lively debate.
Thanks.
And